Hello students, once again yesterday or last lecture I have given you three questions as homework. I hope you might have done. I have now done the solutions for these sums and I am showing you on this video. Just please go through the solutions and the pattern of sums, how to do it, so that your pattern, if you have done it, should match. And if you have not done, please do it and then cross check the answers from this video. Now the first sum, can see I have done the HCF of 135 and 225, where A is 225, which is the greater number, and B is 135, which is the smaller number. Here again the formula, A equals to BQ plus R, where 225 equals to 135 into 1, because 2 times is greater than 225, plus remainder 90. Now 135 will become the dividend, remainder 90 will become the divisor. 90 into 1 plus 45, and the third step, 90 equals to 45 into 2 plus 0, that is the last remainder above 0 is 45, or we can say the line which is the last line of our sum where we got remainder 0, the divisor 45 is our GCD, that is greatest common divisor. 225, 135 is equals to 45. The pattern should be as I have shown you in this video. Second sum I have done, that is 196 into 38220. Here in the very first step only we get the final answer, 196 into 195 plus 0. You can see I have done the division down below, where we can see the remainder is 0. That means in the very first step we have completed our division. So here GCD will be the divisor, that is 196. So greatest common divisor is 196. Third question, that is 867 and 255. Here again 867 is A, 255 is B. Formula A equals to BQ plus R. Here again we have got so many steps, and the last divisor 51, or we can say the remainder above 0, will be our GCD. This way we have to solve these three sums, and you have to make a notebook for it. After the school reopens, I will check the sums which you have done as a homework. Okay, so please make the notebook and start doing sums for maths. If you don't have notebook at present, and because the stationery is closed, you can also make a sheets, take the pin page and make a file of it, and do lesson 1 homework section like this. You can make a file if you don't have any spare notebook, but please do it. Okay, this is my request. Now today we will move further for the next steps which I am going to teach you in this. See, we have learned the formula A equals to BQ plus R. Now I am going to teach you further how to get the solution in the terms of formula. Here I will start some of the explanation in Hindi also, because fully English I think it will be difficult for you to understand. So some points I will say in Hindi and some points I will say in English. Now we will start with the first question, that is show that every positive integer is of the form 2q and 2q plus 1, where 2q is even integer and 2q plus 1 is odd integer. This is the first question which I will help you to understand. In this case, first one, we can see where we have to take the positive integer as A. So first step, let the positive integer be A. Okay, because they have not given and we don't know which is the number. Next they have given, because it is in the form of 2q and 2q plus 1, here b is 2. Okay, and as per our formula we have have learned that remainder is greater than or equal to 0 and less than divisor. Here our divisor is 2, so less than 2. So the possible remainders are 0 and 1 because it will be less than 2. Here this much is clear, r and 1. So if we write in the format a equals to bq plus r, that is a equals to 2q plus 0 and a equals to 2q plus 1. Plus 0 we will not mention, so our actual format will be a equals to 2q and a equals to 2q plus 1. Okay, this is the actual format. Now because this number q is, because we will write like this, q is divisible by 2, so it is an even integer and in a equals to 2q plus 1, where this plus 1 is remainder, therefore 2q plus 1 is odd integer. I'll explain this some once again in Hindi so that some students, those who are not understood, can understand again. यहाँ पे हमें बताना है पॉजिटिव इंटीजर कोई भी हो उसका फॉर्म है 2q और 2q प्लस 1. यहाँ पे 2q में जो प्लेस है bq का, b के जगह पे 2 है. वी विल स्टार्ट विथ, पहले लिखेंगे लेट द पॉजिटिव इंटीजर बी a. अब पॉजिटिव इंटीजर a मीन्स a ऐसा नंबर है जिसको हमें डिवाइड करना है 2 से. ओके, तो फॉर्मेट के हिसाब से b हमारा 2 है, तो फॉर्मूला के हिसाब से रिमाइंडर 2 से छोटा होता है और 0 या 0 से बड़ा होता है. तो रिमाइंडर हमारा पॉसिबल कितना हो सकता है, 0 और 1. उसके हिसाब से दो पैटर्न बनेगा, a इक्वल्स टू 2q और a इक्वल्स टू 2q प्लस 1. नाउ 2q के बाद में कोई भी रिमाइंडर नहीं है, इसीलिए हम इसको लिख देंगे इट इज़ डिविजिबल बाई 2, और 2q प्लस 1 इट इज़ नॉट डिविजिबल बाई 2. और अगर डिविजिबल बाई 2 है तो हमें पता है वो इवन नंबर होगा, और अगर नहीं डिविजिबल बाई 2 है तो वो है ऑड नंबर. अब यही क्वेश्चन हम एक और नंबर के साथ करेंगे, उसमें इससे ज़्यादा डिटेल में एक्सप्लेन करें. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, शो दैट एनी पॉजिटिव ऑड इंटीजर इज ऑफ द फॉर्म 4q प्लस 1 और 4q प्लस 3. Here again we will start the same way. First we will take let a be any positive integer where b is equal to 4. Again same thing, b 4, that means remainder is greater than 0 or equal to 0 and less than b. Here b is equal to 4. Therefore, possible remainders are 0, 1, 2, 3. If you are writing in the standard form a equals to bq plus r, then a equals to, that is 4q, 4q plus 1, 4q plus 2 and 4q plus 3. ठीक है? अभी फिर से एक बार बता रही हूँ, b 4 होगा because the divisor is 4 in both the cases. एंड रिमाइंडर हमेशा डिवाइजर से छोटा होता है, इसलिए वो 4 से छोटा होगा और 0 या 0 से बड़ा होगा. तो 0, 1, 2, 3 उसके रिमाइंडर. और अगर ये पैटर्न में हमें लिखना है तो बनेगा a इक्वल्स टू 4q, 4q प्लस 1, 4q प्लस 2, 4q प्लस 3. यहाँ तक क्लियर हो गया? अभी हमें ये बताना है कि ये पॉजिटिव ऑड इंटीजर है. तो अगर हम 4q और 4q प्लस 2 लेंगे, ये दोनों 2 से डिविजिबल है. यहाँ पे यर a इक्वल्स टू 4q और 4q प्लस 2 आर डिविजिबल बाय 2. देयरफॉर वी कैन से दैट a इज इक्वल टू 4q प्लस 1 और 4q प्लस 3 आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पॉजिटिव और इंटीजर. क्लियर? इसके हिसाब से एक और क्वेश्चन मैं आपको दे रही हूँ जो एक्सरसाइज में भी है और ये आपका होमवर्क बनेगा. दैट इज शो दैट any positive odd integer is of the form 6q plus 1, 6q plus 3 or 6q plus 5. ये आप होमवर्क में सॉल्व कर लीजिए. सेम पैटर्न का सम जैसे मैंने ऊपर क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 में किया है, सेम पैटर्न से करना है और फिर इसको हम कंटिन्यू नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में करेंगे. इसमें और 2-3 सम्स जो है ये एक्सरसाइज में हम बाद में कंटिन्यू करेंगे. तब तक के लिए थैंक यू.